Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll learn how to group shots in the effects environment. This is the ability to take a selection of shots and group them together with a custom name. You can then call up the group at any time for any VFX grading or finishing purposes. This is new functionality with the Flame 2020.1 update, and I'm sure you'll start using it as soon as you see its potential. If you'd like to follow along, just construct a sequence with multiple segments, and you're good to go. So here I have a timeline that has a variety of locations and activities. To start grouping shots together, switch to the Effects Environment via the tab. Now the typical Effects UI layout contains the timeline as a horizontal storyboard reel, and usually this reel depicts every shot in the current video track. Now as a quick reminder, in the previous versions of the Flame products, you could filter these shots down by a selection or metadata. For instance, you could select a few shots and click the filter button. This would isolate the shots in the selection and you could work with them. However, you couldn't make a permanent group. As soon as you turned off filtering and changed the selection, you would have to manually select the shots again and then enable filtering. You could also search by metadata, but this would require every clip to have common metadata to base the search, and then you could create a searchable preset. The shots would be selected, and you could filter that as well. However, this is also not a permanent group, and you can't always ensure matching metadata for a search preset. So these tools only went this far in the previous release. In the Flame 2020.1 update, grouping is now possible in the same familiar environment. All you need to do is make a selection of shots as before. So I'll select the boats and any other sailing activities. Now when there are no groups in the sequence, you will see a grayed out button labeled No Groups. To create a group from the selection, click the plus button. You can also create the group using the context menu. In the text box, I'll call this group Sailing. This is now the currently selected group, as indicated by the pull-down menu. If you enable Filter, the group is now isolated from the rest of the sequence. Now you can have as many groups as you like. For example, disable filtering and choose a fresh selection of shots. I'll choose all the shots from Greece. To create the group, you click the plus button or use the context menu. I'll call this group Greece. As before, if you enable filtering, the group will be isolated from the rest of the sequence. Now, since these groups are permanent, you can toggle between them with the groups pull-down menu. With filtering on, it will only display the shots in the group. With filtering off, the storyboard will show every shot in the sequence, and the shots in the current group will be selected. Now the groups also work when the storyboard is in the viewer. So I'll change the layout to a two-up view where the storyboard is on the left and the storyboard reel is hidden. When no group is selected, the group pull-down menu prompts you to select group. So if I choose either group and enable filtering, it's easy to move between the groups. These groups are saved with your sequence as the groups are pointing to the shots in this edit. So that's how easy it is to make groups and move between them. Now let's say you wanted to remove a shot from the group. Say for instance, you select a shot you'd like to remove. All you need to do is call up the context menu and choose to remove it from the group. If the same shot was in multiple groups, these groups would also be available in the list. When the shot is removed from the group, you won't see it in the filtered group, but it's still in the sequence. Now, if you wanted to add one shot or multiple shots to an existing group, you make your selection and in the context menu, you can add it to any available group. Just as a tip, if your shot already exists in a group, then that group will not be displayed in the list. Ensure you select your group in the pull-down menu, and then you can filter it again if required. Now, one extra feature that is only available when filtering a group is called the custom order. This button is located under the group's controls. When it is off, you get the original timeline order of the shots. However, when you turn it on, you can click and drag the thumbnails into any order you'd like. So it's great for reordering the shots within a group, and there are plenty of times you would use this. If you disable the custom order, the shots will revert to their original order in the edit. But the good news is when you turn custom order on again, it remembers the last state of the reordered shots. So it's a great level of organization within a group. Now, I mentioned earlier that you can have as many groups as you like, but in order to have multiple groups, you need to be able to manage them efficiently. Either through the context menu or pressing this button, you can call up the Manage Groups window. This lists all the groups for the sequence, and you can expand each group to see their contents. You see the names, number of segments in the group, and if you have segments on multiple video tracks, this is also considered as part of the group. Now, the tools work on the group level as well as the shots level. If you call up the context menu over a group, you can copy, duplicate, and rename a group. When it comes to shots, the context menu will allow you to cut, copy, and remove from a group. You can also drag and drop between groups for ease of use. Just using the cursor will move the shot, but holding Shift-Alt and dragging the clip will create a copy of the shot. Just so that you know, if you had two groups using the same shot and you dragged one of them into the other group, it won't create a second instance. Flame will simply highlight the existing shot in the group. Lastly, I did mention that you could have groups comprising of shots from different video tracks. By default, all groups using all video tracks will be displayed. But if you turn on Current Storyboard only, this will hide or grey out items from all video tracks other than the current focus. You can close the Manage Groups window. Now, expanding on from all of this, the Groups takes precedence over the search tools and search presets. In other words, you have the ability to search groups and further narrow down what you're after. Just by calling up the search window, you can choose the criteria to search the current group. As an extra tip, we also added the ability to search for a shot belonging to a particular group. This should cover most of the use cases we've identified when searching in and around the groups. Now, for those of you using the Connected Conform workflow, I would just like to mention that the groups work across multiple connected sequences. So as you add timelines into the workflow, the groups will remain synced across all the connected sequences. For example, shots that are shared across multiple sequences will automatically have groups based on those shots. And if you make changes to the group in any sequence, it will automatically update the group in any other connected conform sequence. The only feature that is not supported with this functionality is custom ordering. Since each sequence is different and may be changed through production, having a synced custom order is simply not possible. Now, if you use the Connected Conform workflow and you don't want the groups to be synced, just open the Flame Main Preferences, go to the Tools and Timeline Effects tab, and disable Connected Conform Groups. Finally, groups are also available in the timeline view. If the group already exists, you can select the group by using the same menus as the timeline search tools and presets. This is located to the bottom right of the timeline view. When you click the pull-down menu next to the timeline search button, the list will contain both searchable presets and groups. You choose your group, and the segments are selected in the sequence. Groups and search presets are combined in this menu, but in the effects environment, they are separate. Now, if you need to create groups, modify, or manage them, you don't need to go back to the effects environment. All these options are available through the Timeline Context menu within the Groups submenu. So that covers the groups in the effects environment and the timeline, and we hope you'll find these useful in the editorial, grading, and VFX contexts. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2020.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.